What's up, guys? Today I'm going to be doing something in the interior of my 240SX today. I'm going to be painting the fabric on my door cards, the fabric on my glove blocks, and I already did some of it, but I wrapped the center console in carbon fiber. So this is how the carbon fiber on the center console came out. Now it is wrapped, it's not actual carbon pieces. The carbon pieces were a lot more expensive. I did this for free. I actually had a lot of wrap left over from the Malibu, so it was easy. Now for paint, I'm gonna be painting this, and that. I'm just gonna be doing them black for right now, and if I wanna do anything a little bit more crazy later on, it'll be a little bit easier to get off since I already know how to kind of get things off. So first things first, we're gonna have to take off the assembly right here, the door handle assembly, and this on this side, and then on this side just the door handle and the power window assembly. Now for this job, you're only going to need three things. You're going to need some masking tape, the vinyl and fabric paint, and a Phillips head screwdriver so that you can get in and take the screw out right there. So yeah, easy enough. We're just going to take those two little pieces off, and then I'll get some masking around since this fabric piece doesn't actually come out of the door card. All right, so I got everything masked off already. Let me go ahead and start spraying it now. Make sure to get every last corner of it. It's nice and black now. I'm just gonna go ahead and let this dry for about 30 minutes, and then I'll go ahead and get started on the next side. All right, now to get the glove box off, there's supposed to be four screws, but I only have three. So when you're opening it, it's gonna kind of look like this. There's gonna be one screw right there, one right here, one right there, and then one right there. Better than the gray. All right, so I put two coats of black on the glove box already. I'm gonna let it dry a little bit, come back, and then do a third coat, and then let it fully cure. While I wait for that, I did go ahead and pick up some red plasti dip. Now I don't know how you guys feel about that, but I love this stuff. I've done a lot with it since high school, and I'm probably gonna continue using it. Now, what I'm going to do with that is I'm going to dip this one spoke on each wheel red to give it kind of the look of a TE37, and then I'm going to come back, and then I'm going to write access. I don't know if I'm going to use a Sharpie or a paint pen or what yet, but yeah, I'll let y'all know. Alright, so I have it completely masked off right now. I'm trying to cover up the dish. And the brakes themselves so that they don't get any plasti dip on them. Now the thing about plasti dip, when you're gonna do something like this, you cannot let the plasti dip dry. You have to spray it give it a light coat, let it sit just a little bit, and then give it a thick coat. And then you have to rip all the masking off while it is still wet, so that the plastic dip doesn't dry and come up with the tape and the rest of the masking. That looks pretty thick. Now I can rip it. Right. And that's how that came out. Now, I did forget to mention, when you're peeling the tape off, make sure that you're doing it at a very sharp angle so that it doesn't come up. I had it happen just a little bit right there, but it's not very noticeable. But yeah, that's what it looks like. I'm gonna go ahead and do the rest of the car without filming, and I'll go ahead and show y'all what everything looks like when it's back together. All right, guys, I'm all done. I went ahead and cleaned up the wheels to make it look a little bit better. Now, I know they're not TE37s, and I'm not saying that they are. I'm not trying to advertise that I have TE37s. Tahoes, they're not six spokes. I have more. That's why I went ahead and had it say access. I really like it. I think it looks pretty cool. Now let's go ahead and look at the interior. Okay, so that actually came out a lot better than I thought it was going to. It's a lot of black now. The whole interior is basically black, except for the seats and the roof now. The glove box came out really good. Now, the only thing I can see kind of weird about this is paint is that it kind of makes the fabric really hard. I mean, it's not really a big issue, but it's a little weird. The carbon fiber wrapped center console. And then the next thing that I'll do, and probably one of my later views, will be to change out the headliner. Alright guys, other than that, I think the interior is going to be basically done. The only thing left that I want to do is put the racing seats. I don't really think there's much else I could do. I need to do the Broadway rearview mirror too, because the one that I have is cracked right now, and I need to do the tint as well. So those three things are the only things that I have left for the interior. As far as like visuals, I mean, I need an amp for the subwoofer as well, but I don't think you're going to be able to see that or even notice. That's going to be more my own preference type of thing. But other than that, guys, if y'all want to see me do anything else to the interior of the car, y'all have any other suggestions or any questions, or want me to show y'all how to do something, go ahead and let me know in the comments below, and let me know of what y'all think about all the stuff that I did today. All right, I'll catch you on the next one. Peace.